Sayyidina Ali radiallahu anhu said, the world is six things. He said, it's ma'kul, wa mashroob, wa malboos, wa markoob, wa mashmoom, wa mankuh. He said, it's something you eat, it's something you drink, it's something you wear, it's something you ride, it's something you smell, or it's something you marry. That's it. And then he said, and look at each one of them. The highest, he said, a'la ma'kul al-asal. The highest thing that you'll eat in this world is the vomit of bees. And he said, the highest thing that you will wear, that you'll drink in this world, is water. And every animal drinks that. We're all the same with water. Everybody needs water. He said, the highest thing that you will wear in this world is silk. And it's the excretion of a worm. He said, the highest thing that you'll smell is musk. And it's the mucus of a gazelle. And the highest thing that you will ride is a horse, and upon it men are killed. And he said, and the thing that you will derive pleasure from your marriage is the meeting place of where you urinate from. That's it. So he said, don't get depressed about that. It's just, you know, when you put it in that perspective, it really doesn't warrant being too depressed about. And now look what this, kamithiri ghayth. It's like a rain that was needed. Ghayth is, matar is rain that comes anyway. Ghayth is the rain that you need. Yughith an-nas, it gives them sustenance. Kaghaythan a'jab al-kuffara nabatuhu. It astonishes or causes to, it delights the farmers, because kufar also means farmer in Arabic. Kafir is the one that covers the earth over the seed. And so the farmer is the one who covers the earth over the seed. The kafir is the one who covers the truth with falsehood. That's why he's a kafir, because he's covering over the truth with this falsehood. He'll make the truth look like it's evil. He'll make it look like it's bad. And that's, they're called, you know, the Greeks called them sophists. And they were, Socrates despised them because he said they make the worse appear to be the better cause. And they did it with language. So, عَجَبْ الْكُفَرْ نَبَاتُهُ ثُمَّ يَهِيدْ. So if you look, like, look, go out there and just look. You know, take a drive up, if you have a afternoon or something on a weekend, take your family out to Muir Woods or something like that, and just look right now how extraordinary all this green is. It's so beautiful. And the Burda talks about when the Prophet raised his hand, sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the rains came down and the hills were turbaned with green silk. And you look out at these hills now, the Oakland Hills, as you pass by, or if you drive down to down here, look at the hills, just look with your eyes. I mean, if you're driving, keep your eye on the road, but look out and just think about that they were all dead and now they're brought back to life, and the eye is delighted by that vision. But that is the nature of the world, because it's not going to last. In 6 weeks, it's all going to be dead again. It'll be yellow. And that's why Allah says that that's the nature of the world. And then it dries up and you see it yellow. And this is a beautiful Quranic nuance here, is that Allah says, that after that, some time elapses. Thumma is after time elapses. Yahiju, it dries up. Yajifu. Fatarahu fa, and then you see it. And this is the thing about it, is the fa occurs after a little bit of time. It's ta'qib, it's just immediately after. But the thing is that sometimes you don't notice. And so you'll see that it becomes musfarra. It doesn't say thumma fatarahu yasfarru, you see it becoming yellow. No, yahiju fatarahu musfarra. It dries up and then you notice that it's yellow. It's no longer green. How did that happen? I mean, it's a very mysterious thing. How did it go from green to yellow? At which point did it become yellow? I mean, it's a very interesting phenomenon. This is a fuzzy logic question. At which point was it no longer green? Because it was green and then it turned into yellow. And it's a very strange phenomenon because at a certain point you suddenly notice it's all yellow. And a little bit before that it was green. And so Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ يَكُونُ حُطَامًا. And then it's blown away in the wind. وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ. You see, I mean, these are signs. Think about this. I mean, are you that much more significant than a blade of grass? That's my creation too. And it worships me. It doesn't disobey me. And I dry it up and turn it into hutam. Just blown away in the wind. Are you that much more significant, really? I mean, that's a question. وَفِرْ آخَرَةِ عَذَابٌ شَدِيدٌ وَمَغْفِرَةٌ مِنَ اللَّهِ. From Allah, this forgiveness that comes from Allah. I mean, that's your state. You're all going to dry up and be blown away, but you'll be raised up. And then there's two possibilities here. Adab or maghfira. And to get maghfira, it doesn't take very much effort. That's the whole point. It's just an admittance. Just admit, I'm your Lord, I created you. Don't be so rebellious. And if you're rebellious, say astaghfirullah. Right? Just say astaghfirullah. I can't help myself. I want to change. وَرِضْوَانٌ وَمَا الْحَيَةُ الدُّنْيَا إِلَّا مَتَاعُ الْغُرُورِ. And this life is nothing but a delusional delight. It's a delight that deludes you because you think it's going to last and it doesn't. And there's been millions of people before us and maybe there'll be millions after us and we're just here in this brief moment in time and we think it's going to last forever and it doesn't. Nothing lasts forever.